Hey folks, Dagan here from PMZV UK, and today I have the pleasure of sharing with you the knowledge that is what on earth do the switches do on Fender Jaguars and Jazzmasters and Mustangs. I was going to show you Mustang, but literally sold just before I was recording that bloody camera, so I'm going to show you a picture of a Mustang. It's the easiest one of the bunch, but yeah, it can be quite intimidating. Fender make lots of wonderful guitars, and when you look at something like a Telecaster with a pickup selector, three-way, volume, tone, super easy. What on earth is all this ridiculousness? It's super easy, and once you know it's a lot of fun to talk about on Jags, Jazzmasters, Mustangs. The possibilities are endless with these guitars and the ones I'm using in this video. 60s Vintera Jag, 60s Vintera Jazzmaster. That's enough chatting, let's get into it. Quick little disclaimer, there's lots of different variations and styles of all of these guitars. They've been modified, that haven't been modified. There's certain switches in, like the Kurt Cobain Jag has the humbuckers on the switch. The Johnny Marr Jag has the selector switch, like a Strat kind of thing. There's lots of different variants, but this is like the main focus of all these guitars. Let's start with the Mustang. As you can see the picture on the screen right now, the most common pickup configuration you'll find on a Mustang and electronic layout is one volume, one tone, two single coils, and two little slider switches above each of those single coils. Now these are three-way slider switches, and when they're in the middle, the pickups are off. And when you slide them one of the two ways, the pickups are on. So say if the neck pickup is slid towards the neck of the guitar itself, and the bridge pickup is still in the middle position, that's the neck pickup engaged. It doesn't matter which way you slide it, it'll turn it on regardless. If you slide both switches the same direction, both pickups will be on in either direction. However, if you slide them in different directions, again, either both facing in or both facing out, that means both pickups are still on. But because the switches are in different directions, that means the pickups are out of phase and you get more of a kind of mid-focus, kind of squawky, honky kind of sound. See, I told you it was easy. Three switches, put them one way and they're on, put them in different directions and it's out of phase. And you get that kind of nasal sound, like a funky second position of a Strat or something. Super easy. Bit more complicated with these lads. So with the Jag and the Jazzmaster, you have the switches up here, which is the rhythm and lead circuit, which I'll talk about in a second. And specifically on the Jaguar, you've got the little three switches down here. Most cases on a Jazzmaster, you'll find the switch down here with the little lead rhythm circuit as well. Now, they do look very similar guitars. They always have done, and that's great. However, there are some very key differences between these two offsets which set them apart. Same with the Mustang as well. The Mustang is obvious, it's got a smaller body and a 24-inch scale length. The Jaguar has a 24-inch scale length, whereas the Jazzmaster has a 25.5-inch scale length. You'll find 21 frets on the Jazzmaster as well, and 22 frets. Usually, like I said, there are different variations on a Jag. And the pickups as well, are worth noting, they'll be the single coil Jag pickups, usually on a Jagmaster, on a Jag you are, and on a Jazzmaster, you'll find the Jazzmaster pickups. But again, it's super easy to just throw a couple of humbuckers in these, or P90s, or whatever you want. But the main differences are the pickups and the scale length. 24 inches on the Jag, 25.5 on the Jazzmaster. Now let's throw on the Jazzmaster quickly and show you what these little switches do on that guy. Notice a change? Haha, that is because it's got a lead and rhythm circuit. So like I say, these guitars don't only just share offset body styles, tremolos, bridges, all that kind of malarkey. They also share the lead and rhythm circuit, which is the little switch up here with two little slidey sideways knob control things. Two-way switch, two slidey knob control things. And what this is an independent volume and tone for the neck pickup or rhythm circuit. This is great for live, because you can put versatility, because you can put different capacitors in here. So you can have a totally different neck pickup sound in the rhythm circuit than you can just by having a neck pickup engaged and the tone circuit right here. As you heard just there, like when it's down. That's in it down, didn't it? How fantastic is that? Again, like I say, there's so many different variations of these guitars with different modifications, like you can coil split humbuckers with these and all that kind of stuff. The majority, lead and rhythm circuit. So when it's down in lead, you have the full bridge pickup active if you want. With the tone control. middle position on a drag. And the neck pickup. When you go to the rhythm circuit, that doesn't do anything. None of this does anything. The only thing that activates is the little volume and tone control for the rhythm circuit. When it's in lead, do what you want, rhythm, do what you want up here. Also, that's a fair shout. You can make it a kill switch. If you turn everything off down the lead circuit and have the rhythm circuit on, you can be like Buckethead. If you wanted to. But yeah, do the same thing on the Jaguar as well if you want. So that is the Jazzmaster switching in this configuration with the little switch down here and the Jazzmaster pickups. Let's go to the Jaguar, where it's a bit more intense because there's three switches down the bottom there. So, same crack with the Jaguar. This is a lead and rhythm circuit, exactly the same. Volume, tone, independent. When this is up, only the neck pickup's active. None of this does anything. When it's down, you'd have lots of fun down here. With the volume and tone control and these three little switches right here. So let's go down to the lead circuit again. Nothing's happening because all the switches are down. The switch closest to the neck is an on-off switch for the neck pickup. The one in the middle is an on-off switch, just two-way, for the bridge pickup. And the third switch, so that's like both pickups on at the same time, which would be both switches up. That kind of thing. And the third switch is a modifier switch, which in the past has been treble cuts, bass cuts, mid cuts. There's so many different things you can do with this. Again, you can hook it up to be coil split for the humbuckers if you want. But standard, in these guitars, it's a strangle switch or like a tone cut. So it takes away some of the lower frequencies, giving it a bit of brightness or like a bit extra brightness when it's up. So. Takes away some of that, the chiminess, that's it, and puts a bit of honk in its place. That kind of makes sense. Again, bridge pickup was only selected down there. Rhythm circuit up here, straight to that neck pickup. This is a lovely guitar. I really like this Jaguar. I'm not much of an offset guy, but this Jaguar is stunning. And just to show the difference in the capacitors, tone circuits, and the neck pickups, this is the neck pickup in the lead circuit. So like standard. So it makes it a little bit softer, makes it a little bit more syrupy, especially if there's a bit of gain. I'll put some gain on this Blackstar St. James. Pretty much it. In essence, what it does, these little switches down here, turn the pickups on and off on a Jaguar, and you've got a little modifier tone cut switch on the end there, closest to the bridge. That's got a regular select switch. Both have rhythm and lead circuits. That turns it on, disables everything down here, and only lets you use this as a volume and this as a tone for the neck pickup on both these guitars. And the Mustang had its own little thing as well. But yeah, if you want to expand on anything that I spoke about in this video, please comment down below. share the love, write your own little fun fact about the Jazzmaster Jaguar or Mustang, because I want to hear it as well. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to PMTV UK here on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music-related content. We are playing music today on all social media pages. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.